Happy New Year, Vipers! Welcome to your Vandy announcements on the Vandegrift Broadcast System. That's Lyra Williams.
And that's Dana Ung. Today is Wednesday, January 4th. The weather this week has lows in the 40s and highs in the 70s. There will be sunny days all week except for Saturday, with a 40% chance of rain.
Now to sports. What's new, what's happened, and what to expect. On Saturday, December 17th, the Viper football team faced off against the DeSoto Eagles for the 2022 UIL Texas Football State Championship. The Vipers fell to the Eagles 42-17, but played with the resilience that carried them so far this season. Their second-place state finish ends a record-setting football season with 14 wins and 2 losses. Photos covering their playoff run can be seen on the Vandegrift Voice website.
On December 28th and 29th, the varsity boys basketball team played a series of matches, winning against the Summer Creek Bulldogs, Ray High School, and the Wagner Thunderbirds before losing to Glenn High School. On the same days, the girls varsity basketball team played against Weiss, Leander, and Burnett, with the score in their latest game 52-42 Burnett. Last night, both the varsity boys and girls basketball teams played against Maynard. The boys won the away game 49-43, and the girls lost their home game 55-48. This Friday, both varsity boys and girls basketball play against McNeil at 7 p.m., with boys at home and girls away. I hope to see everyone cheering in the stands.
On December 30th, the varsity boys soccer team played a match against Johnson High School, winning 4-1. The team also has multiple away games. On Thursday, they play against Red Oak High School at 6:10 p.m. Friday, they play Harker Heights at 2:30 p.m. And Saturday, they play Eastview at 4:10 p.m. Go to any one of these games at Georgetown High School Stadium to support the boys' varsity soccer team.
The varsity swimming team has an away meet on Saturday at 12 p.m. against Cedar Ridge High School. Support our Viper swimmers by attending.
Parking permits have been available for a whole semester. We hope you have one, but if you don't, you can register online and pay at the link below. Remember, tickets are being handed out and you will receive one if you don't possess a permit.
Seniors, make sure to order your cap and gown before January 15th to avoid a late fee. You can pay at the link below.
The National PTA is calling for students to compete in the annual Reflections program, which encourages students to pursue artistic expression. Students can create and submit their entries in 6 areas: literature, musical composition, photography, dance choreography, film production, and visual arts. This year's theme is Show Your Voice. To learn more, visit the link below. Registration is open until February 1st.
Vandy Voice's latest article by editor Abby Links talks about the Austin Animal Center and the growing demand for pet shelters. Read more in the most recent Vandegrift Voice article. Teachers, if you have an announcement or want an event in your class to be featured in our broadcast, submit a request here at the AV website.
Thank you for joining us today. This has been your Vandy Announcements from VBS. Until next time. I'm Dana Ung.
And I'm Lyra Williams.
Stay classy, Vandy!